Thank you all so much for coming out this afternoon. Means a lot to me. It's hard to believe this is my third organ recital here since beginning my work as music director and organist and choir director at Calvary. That piece was a toccata on Lift Every Voice and Sing by Summit's own Mark Miller, who's the organist at a church just down the road. When I was putting together a Pride Month recital and wanted to highlight LGBTQIA composers and BIPOC composers, I thought, what better piece than to take a beautiful hymn by two black brothers that was set by a wonderful composer who's still alive, and just opened it with a note of celebration and joy, just recognizing the diversity and beauty of all of God's children. The next piece is by Calvin Hampton. It is the first of four suites on this program. Those of you familiar with organ repertoire, you may hear the first movement's a homage to Dupré's Cortege and Litanies. The second movement is influenced by early Messiaen, and the last movement is influenced by the works of Jean Alain with his syncopated dialogue between different manuals. For those of you who don't know Calvin Hampton, he was an Episcopalian organist for most of his life, which was tragically cut short by AIDS in 1984. This was one of the last pieces he wrote. It was commissioned by Wayne Leopold, and you can hear this I believe he was knew he was sick by the time he was writing it, and you can hear this thoughts on eternity and this quiet prayer transforming to joy. The piece after that is Chelsea Chen's Taiwanese Suite. Chelsea is a young organist, originally from California. She studied at Juilliard and Yale. She wrote this suite on Taiwanese folk songs dedicated it to her father. And if you hear, you can hear these short folk songs from Asia, which if you've seen maybe a Studio Ghibli film, it might remind you of some of the scores for that, where these melodies just float through freely over the organ. So I hope you enjoy Calvin Hampton's three pieces and Chelsea Chen's Taiwanese Suite.
Thank you.
The next suite on the program is by Florence Price, whom has exploded in recognition in the past 5 or so years. Florence Price was the first black woman to have a symphony performed by a major U.S. symphony orchestra, and she was also an organist who wrote many pieces for organ. Her suite for organ is my favorite of her organ works. You can hear her training in the classical French tradition, but also deeply influenced with blues and jazz music of the music she would have grown up listening to. And these four short movements are a really beautiful merging of those two worlds. Krista Rakish she's been in Connecticut, Massachusetts, and Oberlin, but she is a phenomenal organist and teacher. She's now teaching at Oberlin as the chair of the organ department. Her homage on Gershwin is a beautiful short piece she wrote for a friend of hers. It is the jazziest hymn tune rendition you will ever hear. You'll hear both Gershwin and the hymn tune Slain. For those of you who don't know what a quadlibet is, it's a medley of music done in a sort of like intellectual exercise. So I hope you enjoy that piece. Finally, my suite for organ. I wrote this a few years ago, I think when I was home with COVID, unable to practice and just wanted to write a piece. So each one of these three movements is dedicated to three very close friends of mine from graduate school. I took their names and I arranged the seven notes that we have in the seven letters that form the notes in the music. Then I lined up the rest of the alphabet, making a grid underneath it. So I spelled out their names, and that was how I derived the musical material for each movement. And then tried to write in a style of a piece or a compositional style that each of the dedicatees really appreciated and enjoyed. So the first one, the prelude, is a brooding kind of pianistic solo, because the friend who was dedicated to is a very good pianist and was a pianist before she was an organist. The pastoral is from a friend who grew up on a farm and loves nature and outdoors, so I hope you can hear the frolicking dancing outdoors and the soft rainstorm that comes in before the sun returns. And the toccata is a organ virtuoso piece for a friend of mine, incorporating, if you know it, little bits of the Roibke Sonata on the 94th Psalm, Vierne's Third Symphony First Movement, and the Vidor Roman, because those were three pieces he loved and was working on at that time. So I hope you enjoy the rest of the program. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. Please join us for a reception in the choir room just through these doors. And if you enjoyed today's recital, we are appreciative of any donations, which will go to the Calvary Music Program so we can have more guest artists and more recitalists come through over the course of the year. Thank you.